In this session, we'll learn to use the descriptive statistics function, and you'll notice I've opened that for you here. It's under the toolbox, and for this demonstration, I'm going up here to Tools, and I'm going to open the Data Manipulator and generate some random data. I've already selected that I want 12 rows of data with a mean of 100 and a standard deviation of 15. More properly, I want 12 data randomly drawn from a population like that. So let's take the data that we have generated, copy it, and paste it over here and see what happens. You can think of descriptive statistics as sort of the compression algorithm for data. It's not lossless. You do lose some information, but it's kind of the way that you can take a big, nasty, ugly collection of data and talk about it meaningfully with just a few numbers. Okay, three things that we look for as we do our descriptive statistics. Number one, where's the middle of the distribution? Number two, how spread out are the data around the middle? And number three, what's the shape of the distribution? So let me take those in a little different order. First thing we can look at is, according to the Anderson-Darling normality test, we cannot detect any non-normality, so we're justified in assuming that the data are normally distributed. And that's handy. Here's a histogram of the data. Now, sometimes people are a little shocked when they see histograms of small data sets. That doesn't look very normal, but truly it is. If you enlarge the size of the sample, then you'll see that you get something closer and closer to a normal distribution. Okay, measures of the middle are right up and down this column. And in the middle of all that is the mean. The mean is 96.63. The median, the 50th percentile, we have as much data below this as we do above, is 97.12. And the trimmed mean is 97.5. The trimmed mean is calculated after you throw out outliers. And if that's very different from this mean, it means that your data are probably a little bit skewed, okay? So the next issue is how spread out are the data. That can be measured by standard deviation or by range. On larger groups of data, we prefer standard deviation. On small subgroups, range works very well. This is the one that is probably center stage for you. This is sigma sum of squares, 15.85. This is the standard usual way that standard deviation is calculated. This, on the other hand, is standard deviation calculated by the moving range method. Now, we use that in process behavior or control charts, and we use that in capability. Okay, let's see. Where next? Oh, confidence intervals. Around the mean, we have this 95% confidence interval. It says that if we drew this size sample again and again from this population, that 95% of the time, we would get a mean between 86.56 and 106.7. Similarly, we've got 95% confidence intervals on our standard deviation. That could be anywhere between 11.23 and 26.91. Okay, what have we left out? Kurtosis, if you're center heavy or tail heavy in your distribution, you may have something in kurtosis. Skew simply means that the distribution has kind of been pushed to one side. Here are our nonparametric measures, min, max. Difference between those two is the range, of course. First quartile, 25% of the data are below that. Median, 50% are below. Third quartile, 75% are below. The only things left, I guess, are to point out that we had 12 data, and then these relate to my Anderson-Darling test up here. So pretty simple, and gives you a pretty complete rundown on what the data look like in a condensed version.